I have something to admit. When I got a big gaming desktop to try out and review, I spent a lot of time, well, not reviewing it. After making my own channel, I wanted to get into new categories of tech, but I soon found out that I'm just not all that experienced at reviewing things that don't fit in my pocket. So for quite a while, this desktop became a fixture of my office, the glowing LED centerpiece that powered my daily work, my editing, and my gaming. And now that I'm about to give back this review unit, I've realized something. The fact that something so menacing, so flashy, so powerful felt so at home on my desk is the story, and I've been reminded about how useful and thus how reliable a balls-to-the-wall gaming machine like this can be. Hey, it's Joshua Vergara. What's going on, everybody? Let me give you some thoughts on the Zotac Mech Ultra, this beast of a gaming PC. For some context, I do need to give you some thoughts on my daily computing. I'm mostly a mobile user, opting for a powerful but ultra-portable laptop most of the time. And right now, laptops are really hitting a stride. I can get a lot of editing done and quite a bit of gaming on a laptop like the MateBook X Pro, sometimes with the help of a Thunderbolt-connected eGPU. But desktops are still the pinnacle of performance, with processors and video cards reaching such new heights that current high-end rigs can be fairly future-proof. And even then, desktops by their nature can be forever because you can keep upgrading the parts. This is probably nothing new for most of you watching. You might already be a veteran PC builder, scoffing at the fact that I would recommend a pre-built system. But have a look at this, my current desktop. There's even some dust inside. This is a capable rig, but doesn't really have a coherent design from head to toe. I had all of the parts recommended to me by some colleagues, and then I had the people over at Fry's Electronics put it all together. I know, I'm losing my geek cred by the sentence here. But this shows you where I'm coming from in the world of desktop computers. I want to build my own rig someday, but sometimes you need an example to be inspired to DIY. And let me tell you, everything about this Mech Ultra has opened my eyes to the fantastical world of desktop gaming PCs. Zotac does not shy away from flashy bits and pieces. LEDs are strewn about the casing, especially the iconic lit-up pattern on the front. A glass panel included in the box helps make the internals easier to view, or honestly to show off, with the Zotac logo again prominently placed on the inside. Glowing LEDs make light of the cooling systems that include fans and liquid, and there is a slight hum, but it gives the desktop an almost hypnotic vibe alongside the breathing LED. And then whenever you fire up a game or do a couple of benchmarks perhaps, you can hear that rev up and the power is really tangible. The RTX 2080 is prominent and a massive increase in performance gains from the GTX 970 found in my previous desktop. Now, ray tracing is a huge part of the gaming equation here, as well as the 11GB of VRAM that almost triples the amount in my GTX 970. Expansion bays are aplenty, but the included 2TB storage drive takes me a while to fill up anyway. And the Intel i7 Coffee Lake processor in this Z370 motherboard holds it all together, an evolution almost 4 years past my previous rig. Okay, let me talk about benchmarks for a second. I did run a few. After all, the Mech Ultra actually came with a lot of different applications for that very purpose. But there are a ton of places where you can see the empirical performance of this desktop and each piece that makes it up. Because I don't really have a pedigree with computer reviews to begin with, I don't have any previous reference points. So I just wanted to provide my current setup as context and then give you my experience comparing the new to the old. But with all of that in mind, there should be no surprises here. The Mech Ultra is light years better than the setup I have now. I see where PC gaming is going because of how well Zotac here meets the needs of the present day gamer. I talked a little bit about ray tracing earlier. Obviously, that means that games like Shadow of the Tomb Raider will look exceptional compared to any non-RTS experience. My GTX 970 just gets smoked, and buttery smooth 60fps is an inevitability here rather than a mostly achievable endeavor. I've even been disappointed by my 1070 gaming box that I use with the MateBook X Pro, where it has struggled with exceptionally intensive games like Assassin's Creed Origins and Odyssey. I know the CPU is more to blame in that case, but the fact remains that such situations helped the Mech Ultra just slide itself into my computing life as a reliable comfort zone. But great gaming isn't the only reason why I love this thing. It has definitely elevated my editing bay with render times that benefit not just from the graphics upgrade, but particularly the CPU upgrade. I don't do a lot of graphics or 3D work in my videos, as you might know, but I will always appreciate any improvement in my workflow. So these are just some light thoughts that I have on a computer that has actually elevated my office here and my workflow, something that has made itself at home on my tabletop. And honestly, when this desktop goes away, I'm gonna miss having it around. it made for a great replacement for my current desktop. And even though I really love having portability via a notebook, just sitting down at my desk in my office became such a comfort. I could work or play without fear of any issues. Honestly, I'm still intimidated by the prospect of building my own desktop in the future, but that's a story for later. What matters now is that I just experienced some of the best that PCs have to offer, and I know I'll be itching to get back to that soon. Of course, if I end up caving and I don't make my own desktop in the future, I can always get something like the Mac Ultra for myself. And that's not actually a bad idea because of a starting price of around $1,900. That sounds like a lot, but for a computer that has top tier specs and should hold up for at least the next couple of years, people looking for a powerful rig can easily add the Zotac Mac Ultra to the shortlist. For now though, I'm happy to have experienced one of Zotac's current powerhouses, and I hope to do more computing content in the future, so keep it tuned to my channel for that and even more, potentially things on desktops, laptops, and even gaming content. However, I do playthroughs and Let's Plays over on a separate channel called JV Plays Games. The upcoming breadth of videos that you will see on JV Plays Games was recorded on the Zotac Mac Ultra. So from there, you can go ahead and just subscribe to this and that channel and hit the bell on the side so you can keep up with everything that I'm up to. And from there, I'll just see you on my next video. And until then, I'll just remind you to enjoy your tea, everybody.